Prime Minister Nour al-Maliki ended 8 years of tumultuous rule in Iraq yesterday. He resigned as Prime Minister in a surprise move that avoids a potential constitutional crisis. Mr. Maliki had disputed in court the naming of another politician to the premiership. His concession came after intense pressure from other Shiite members of his political movement, Shiite religious figures, and from the US and Iraq's close ally, Iran. The new Prime Minister, Haider al-Abadi, will have to face up to militants who have conquered about a quarter of the country in the last 2 months.
Domestic and international pressures meant Mr. al-Maliki had to step down. We hope that the new designated Prime Minister will correct past mistakes. The new Prime Minister has two main tasks to achieve. The first is to fight terrorism, and the second is to fight the financial corruption which has prevailed in government institutions.
Mr. Maliki had earlier assured his supporters that he wouldn't relax his grip on power until Iraq's High Court had ruled on his complaint. US officials hope Iraq will now move toward a more united front against Islamic militants such as the Islamic State. During his Thursday night speech, Mr. Maliki was surrounded by top leaders from his own Shiite political party, including Mr. Abadi, who stood directly to his right.